Namaste. Welcome to Geeta's Kitchen. Today is the Naivedyam for day 9 of Navaratri, which we celebrate as Saraswati Puja. So the simple Naivedyam here. Here I have a payasam. I am going to make of a combination of moong dal and chana dal. I have taken quarter cup of each. Washed and added water to it. We are going to make coconut rice. You can take water in the proportion of 1:2. And this is the green chana which I got this time. So I am going to make a sundal of this green chana. If you don't have green chana, you can use the kala chana. Or you can use the white karamani or lobia. Whatever you have, you use. So first we will cook all these three together in the pressure cooker. We place all the pans. And as usual, I am just adding a pinch of salt to the chana for cooking. We will cook everything for 3 whistles. Meanwhile, for the payasam, we can make the jaggery syrup and keep ready. Add the jaggery to the water and just allow it to come to a boil and dissolve. See, it is enough if the jaggery just dissolves. Now we can remove this, keep it aside. We are going to make coconut rice, so let's make the tempering for that also and keep ready. Heat about 3 teaspoons of oil in a kadai. Add some mustard seeds, urad dal, a little bit of chana dal, some ground nuts, 1 dry red chilli, 2 pieces of chopped green chilli and curry leaves. Fry it till the dals are well roasted. Then we can even add a little bit of hing to this. And now we'll add our fresh grated coconut and stir fry everything together for a couple of minutes. Add some salt also. You can even add a few pieces of cashew nut. I forgot to add it at the beginning. I am adding it now. Just stir it till it slightly changes color to a reddish color. Switch it off. We will keep this aside. So now we have opened the pressure cooker. The dal is cooked and ready. The chana is also cooked. Rice also, I have taken it out and transferred it just to cool down. So first for the payasam, we will take this dal in a bowl. To this, we can add this jaggery syrup which we had made right at the beginning. Mix it well. Just allow it to come to a boil once again. This has come to a boil now. I am just transferring it into another bowl. Now let this just cool down a bit, then we will add boiled and cooled milk to it. Very often people tell me that it gets curdled when you add milk to the jaggery. So just allow it to come down, the temperature come down a bit, then we will add the milk. Meanwhile, see this rice, so I have just allowed it to cool. You can add just a teaspoon of oil to it. Then add this roasted coconut and other ingredients which we have fried and kept ready at the beginning, and mix everything well together. Just adding some salt to this. Mix everything with a light hand so that the grains still remain separate. Finally, for the sundal, as usual, just take about 2 teaspoons oil in a kadai, some mustard seeds, urad dal, 1 dry red chilli, a few green chillies and curry leaves, some hing, next we will add in this cooked chana. adding some salt to it. Mix it well till the water is all absorbed. Finally, add a teaspoon of fresh grated coconut, and I have some of my sundal powder, a teaspoon of that. The recipe for the sundal powder I have done on the day when we made the kabuli chana sundal, that is, we dry roasted chana dal, dry chilies and a little bit of coriander and made it into a powder. So use that, switch it off. Quickly squeeze half a lemon, juice of half a lemon into it. It is then ready to be offered as naivedyam. Now for the final touches to the payasam, I have heated a teaspoon of ghee. We will add some cashew nuts to it and fry. Next, add some raisins also. Pour this over the payasam. We'll add some cardamom powder for flavor. And finally, we can add milk as much as required. This is boiled and cooled milk. Mix it well. The Naivedyam for day 9 of Navaratri, which we celebrate as Saraswati Puja, is also ready. We have the Moong Dal and Chana Dal Payasam, coconut rice, green chana sundal, and this is the traditional Naivedyam of Thiril and Gud, that is sesame seeds, white sesame seeds I have roasted, and little bit jaggery I have added to it and made it into a powder. Thank you for watching the video. Out of these, make whatever is possible for you and offer it with devotion to Devi. We will now proceed with the story of the Devi Saptashati for day 9. Sarva Mangala Mangalye Shive Sarvartha Sadhake Sharanye Triyambake Devi Narayani Namostati. By the grace of Mother Narayani, we have now entered the 9th day of Navaratri. And this leads us to the 13th and final chapter of the Devi Mahatmyam. This chapter deals with the results which the king Suratha and the trader Samadhi got after their worship of Mother Devi. So, if you come back to the story of both Suratha and Samadhi, traveling aimlessly because of their attachment, they are very unhappy, and they then go to Rishi Medhas and ask him why their mind is so full of confusion. Then Rishi Medhas has told them the story of this throughout these 9 days, and Rishi Medhas now tells the king Suratha and the trader Samadhi, now I have told you the story of the greatness of Devi, the Devi Mahatmyam. So you can now very well understand that she is the cause of the all the existence in the world, the living and non-living things, as well as she is the one who is present in our mind also. So it is now for you to pray to her. This Maya of the Devi is what results in your attachment towards either your country or your people also, as in the case of the Vaishya, his own family had cheated him, and now you pray to Devi for her grace. It is her grace alone which again will remove that feeling of confusion and attachment from your mind. So both the king and the Vaishya are now very happy with the blessings of the sage. Then, as advised by the sage, they go and do penance on the banks of a river for a number of years, meditating on the Universal Mother. So after many years of penance, the mother, she is happy with their penance and appears before them. She says, now that you have understood and you have done a lot of penance, You tell me what you want. I'm happy with your devotion. And then the king, she first asked the king. The king Suratha says, I want to get my country and my kingdom back. And I will be very happy with that. So Mother Devi says, okay, so be it. I grant that you will get back your kingdom. And not only your kingdom, you will get another 60,000 more countries also. And you will be known as the 8th Sarvari Manu. So then the king is very happy with that. Then she asks this Vaishya by the name of Samadhi. She says, now what do you want? I am happy with your devotion and penance also. Samadhi says, I want nothing other than your grace. I just want to be at your feet all the time and gain your knowledge. That is all that I want. And she says, so be it. You will get all the knowledge and wisdom. And at the end of that, you will also get your liberation or moksha. So Samadhi is also very happy. And so the king goes back to his country and he is crowned as king and he reigns for a very long time. And Samadhi joins the hermitage of sage Medhas, developing his knowledge and wisdom. And with his aim to become one with Devi and get her grace too. So, in conclusion, a quick recollection. The story begins with the king named Suratha and the Vaishya named Samadhi. They meet the sage named Medhas. What does this all really mean? The king Suratha, Ratha means chariot. So, we can think of our body as a chariot. And Samadhi refers to the mind. And Medhas refers to intellect. So when the mind controls the body in a proper way and good intellect, it listens to the intellect, then our life is very smooth. But then what happens if we think of our body as the chariot, then the different sense organs are the various horses which are driving the chariot and our buddhi is the charioteer. So if the buddhi is able to control these sense organs and to prevent their moving away towards unnecessary vishayas, unnecessary sensory pleasures or unnecessary attractions, then we will have a very smooth journey of life. So then the manas, the mind, is represented by Samadhi, which means you should have totally focused attention. That is why both of them then go to meet the sage Medhas. Medhas represents wisdom or intellect. So when they go with their confusion to the sage, the intellect clarifies everything and tells them that these are not permanent things. Both Suratha was going behind his kingdom and his wealth. Samadhi was attached to his own family. But Medhas, the intellect, tells them that these are not permanent things in your life. They will keep on changing. You will have good times and bad times. But what remains always is the power of the Universal Mother, whose grace we should always strive to get. But even at the end of all that, the King Suratha still has not got rid of all his attachment and he still wants to get back his kingdom. Whereas the Vaishya, the trader, Samadhi, has understood. He now has gained this wisdom. He loses his attachment and he has overcome the sense of I-ness, that is Ahankara, and mine, that is Mamakara. That is what all of us should strive for. So let us pray to Devi to bless us so that we are also able to overcome this sense of I and mine, our Ahankaram and our Mamakara, so that we also are able to get detachment and thereby gain the ultimate wisdom. So our prayers to the Ma Durga, Ma Lakshmi and Ma Saraswati to bless all of us always and give her grace to us so that we are blessed with good health and all auspicious things in our life. May the entire world be happy. In conclusion, let us again repeat the Saptashloki as we did on the very first day. Jnani Namapi Chetamsi Devi Bhagavati Hisar Balada Krishya Mohaya Mahamaya Prayachati Durge Smrita Harisi Bhiti Mashisha Janto Swasthe Smrita Matimativa Shubham Dadasi
दारिद्र्य दुख भयहारिणी का त्वदन्य सर्वोपकार करणाय सदार्थ चित्त सर्वमंगल मांगल्ये शिवे सर्वार्थ साधिके शरण्ये त्र्यंबके देवी नारायणी नमोस्तुते शरणागत दीनार्थ परित्राण परायणे सर्वस्यार्थि हरे देवी नारायणी नमोस्तुते सर्वस्वरूपे सर्वेशे सर्वशक्ति समन्विते भयेभ्यास्त्राहिनो देवी दुर्गे देवी नमोस्तुते रोगान शेषान अपहंसि तुष्टा रुष्टात कामान सकलान भीष्टान त्वामाशितानां न विपन्नराणां त्वामाशिताह्याशयतां प्रयन्ति सर्वबाधा प्रशमनं त्रैलोक्यमस्यकिलेश्वरी एवमेव त्वया कार्यं अस्मत् वैरि विनाशनं.
थैंक यू फॉर वाचिंग द वीडियो. थैंक यू फॉर बीइंग विद अस ऑन दिस स्पिरिचुअल जर्नी ऑन द 9 days. It really felt like family, this huge YouTube family of Geeta's Kitchen. And this has been a very, very humble attempt on my part to even try to explain the Devi Mahatmyam to you. I am not very well versed in the Shastras, nor do I have a great knowledge of Sanskrit. I am only sharing with you whatever I have learnt from my parents, elders, and all others, family members, all others who have given me and shared with me their knowledge too. And of course, many insightful articles which I have read, from which I have also shared that knowledge so that everyone can benefit. I request all elders to pardon me for any mistake which I might have committed, either in the pronunciation or in the meaning of the way I have told the Devi Mahatmyam to you. And all this would definitely have not been possible without the blessings and grace of the Universal Mother, Ma Durga, and the blessings of my Guru Paramacharya. May Shri Mata bless all of us with good health, and may the entire world be happy. Sarve jana sukhino bhavantu. Jai Ma Ambe. Jaya Jaya Shankara. Hara Hara Shankara.